I was an army brat, and before that a sailor's brat. I went to 4 elementary schools and 3 high schools. I grew up with change. I was an only child, and I am now living in my 35th place of residence. Summer cottage in wartime, in midwinter in northern Ontario. The 3 of us in one room, because housing was so tight in wartime. And we were aboard ship for a year. Always going into new groups and try to fit in. Country 2-room school with girls in cheap summer dresses with short sleeves and long underwear down to the wrist. Mother sent me off with neatly made sandwiches with celery curls and carrot sticks. The others ate bacon grease on homemade bread. I moved to the States, short distance, but needed a lot more adaptation. There was not much immigration in the 50s, and my names for things and my pronunciation struck people as odd. Again, I worked to fit in, and many times I don't think I made it. The teasing made me stick to my way too much. Meeting new people with new ways is one of the delights of travel. For instance, driving from London to Genoa, we stopped at a bed and breakfast in France. There I was with a group of women in the dining room who made a fuss over my year-and-a-half-year-old son. They were charming and had some English, so we chatted away quite happily until my husband came and took me away and told me that they were prostitutes. When working in the OR in Kenya, we would talk about the different peoples in Kenya. The Somalis do this, the Kikuyu do that, and the Luya dance like this. So I showed them how we danced in the early 60s, and they fell about laughing. In London, one went shopping every day. It was amazing to think we spoke the same language, and their names for every vegetable was different. It was the thing to put one's child out in the pram any day it wasn't actually pouring. Not that London smog seemed especially good for children. What a joy to be walking down the street in a fog and then look up to see that one is on Baker Street, or that odd-looking store is the old curiosity shop. I succeeded in somehow getting away from my tour in Istanbul twice. The people were so kind. One man walked me to the train station and waited to see that I got on the right train. Such a pleasure to see the dogs walking down the streets with no one with them, looking like the other busy people with some place they needed to be, wearing a little plastic tag that tells the community that they have had their shots and been checked before going back to the streets. A hotel had a sign, "Please don't feed the cats, the kitchen staff take care of them." One feels the amazement in Kenya that the lions are real and there are news eating not that far away. It is marvelous to wake up in camp and look up to the Rockies and be able to spend the day in the shadow of that magnificence.